Emmanuel Namunyu Memorial High School ni shule ambayo jina lake Emmanuel Namunyu Memorial ni jina ambalo ni la baba yangu ambaye ni alikuwa mwanzilishi wa shule hii mwaka 2013 na baadaye akaaga mwaka wenyewe. Baadaye nikaja nikabadilisha jina la shule kwa hali ya kuweza kumkumbuka ukumbusho wake, ndipo tukaipa jina Emmanuel Namunyu Memorial High School. Kwa hivyo shule hii ilianza mwaka wa 2013 na wanafunzi wa chache hivi, na mara ya kwanza tumefanya mtihani ni mwaka wa 2016. Tumefanya 16, 17, 18, 19 na 20. Kwa hivyo tuna wanafunzi kwa shule hii. Saa hii idadi ya wanafunzi wamefika 250. Na pia tunapoangalia kwamba matokeo yetu ni mazuri, tunaangazia matokeo ambayo yamefanywa hasa mwaka ambayo imepita ya 2019 na 2020. Tunapata ya kwamba 2019 tuliweza kupeleka wanafunzi 16 chuo kikuu, na pia 2020 tumepeleka wanafunzi 14 chuo kikuu. Na vile vile matokeo yetu yamekuwa bora kutokea mwanzo mpaka hivi sasa. Wanafunzi wetu wamekuwa wanafanya vizuri na wanaenda vyuo vikuu vya kiserikali, na hapo tunasema asante kwa wazazi ambao wanatupa watoto pamoja na jamii zote ambazo tunakaa nao katika vijiji hapa shuleni. Tunapata kwamba pia ni wazuri na shule yetu inaendelea vizuri kutokana na mambo yao ya kuwa watu wazuri kwa jamii pamoja na wanafunzi. Alafu tunapata kwamba sisi shule yetu iko na mazingira mazuri. That's the environment is good. We do have dormitories za wasichana, dormitories za wavulana, na pia tuna classes is a two streamed school and boys and girls mixed full boarding, so all the learners just stay in the school compound and their discipline is good. Staffing, tuko na walimu. For now we have around 20 teachers and around 10 and teaching staff in our school who are working hard to ensure that everything is going on well. At the same time, tuko na security nzuri kwa shule. Kuna walinzi wa shule na pia shule yenyewe pia imeweza kuwekwa fence na ulinzi ni nzuri. Kwa hivyo ukiwa mzazi, tunakuomba kwamba unaweza tuletea watoto kwa shule hii, na sisi tunaona ni bora kwa sababu tutamwezesha mtoto wako kufanya vizuri. Na alama ambayo tunachukua mwanafunzi lazima awe amepata alama 250 kwenda juu ili tukaweze kumchukua na akaweze kusoma katika shule hii. Kitu kingine ni kwamba kumekuwa na some challenges kwa private schools in terms of the primary private schools. Pengine wewe ni mzazi uko na mtoto private school na umeshindwa mahali ambapo unaweza mpeleka. Our school is the best school and also is a school where you can take your child. If it's from private school, this is also a private school that can take care of your child well, the way you expect, and you can have the best. It is also a Christian school. It's a school that does not only produce academicians, but an all-round student. Also, we teach them the good values that they can acquire in the society and everywhere that they go. We are also having some challenges where you find that probably if your child is not selected in a school that you did not like, we sometimes parents go for those other schools, they look for them and they lack opportunities. But for us in our school, we have opportunities and our school is full boarding. So wherever you are, you can just still contact us and find that there's a place for you and your child to learn. Then another thing is that I want to thank because of some public people, like for example the members of parliament. There are some constituencies that give us funds when they realize that our children are in this school. Like for example, the Bumula, we have the member of parliament, that's Mwambu Mabonga. We thank him because he has supported some few children in our school. I want also to thank Webuye Dan Wanyama. He has also supported our children, and Mheshimiwa Waruke from Sirisha constituency. He has also done it.
And also want to thank our MCA of West Nyalondo. He has also done the same, and also the Siboti MCA. And others from places like West Pokot and others, I've seen them giving us some bursary. So I want to encourage you, some of you probably think that in private school, they are not supported by the government, but what I know is that the government has goodwill for our children, and all our children perform well based on how we are taking care of them. So if you have any need, you can even ask for bursaries, and sometimes those well-wishers, like those members of parliament I've named, they can support you. I also want to tell you that we are having 2021 candidates whom we are aiming at performing well, and we have several strategies we want to use. One, we have teamwork. Number one, we believe in God. Number two, we have teamwork. Then number three, we have to ensure that we cover the syllabus as early as possible, and also teach our children to learn how to make revision in a better way so that they can achieve the best. So we are aiming at the best grade come the year 2021. And remember, even 2021, we are going to have like two classes in the year 2022, those in Form 2 and Form 3 will take exams the same year. So we need to thank all the parents and appreciate you, support your children wherever they are so that they may learn in a good way. In our school, the school is under the church. Our church, the name of the ministry is known as Hope and Light Christ Ministries. Our children go to church from 6:30 on Sunday in the morning to 8:30. That's when they get out of the church every Sunday. Then every Wednesday they go to for spiritual nourishment also, and they have to be preached on from 4 to 4:30 or 4 to 5, depending on how it takes. But the program mostly is for 1 hour, but it takes time based on how it is, either before 1 hour ends or after 1 hour itself. Then also we have guiding and counseling session that takes place every Tuesday. The teachers on duty, they have to do the guiding and counseling, and we have topics that have been set up that we use in doing counseling. Then we have teachers whom we have given assigned the children. Every child has a parent in the school, a teacher who is a parent and is in charge of the child. So when this child has challenges or anything, the child can still conduct that teacher who is a parent.
So we were saying that the reaction between hydrochloric acid and ammonia, it will form ammonium chloride.
We are saying that compound complex sentence is a combination of a compound and complex sentence.